Hi guys, this is Steven, a sales manager from Top Flight Tech. In today's video, I am going to introduce our BLE door and temperature sensor, TSDT1-B. Please note that the temperature detection is not as sensitive as our temperature and humidity sensor. You can consider this function as a reference. The main feature is still for monitoring the door status. So our door sensor is designed for the sake of security by sending out alert to remind us whether the door is closed or not. Here's the logic of how they work. We place the sensor and the magnet parallel and next to each other. The distance must be within 3 centimeters. If the distance between them is more than 3 centimeters, the sensor will consider the door is open and will send you the alert immediately. Now let's start with the features it carries. First, it is designed with the waterproof IP60 feature, which allows it to endure in the extreme weather, such as snowing and rainstorm. Second, it is the replaceable battery, which is up to 6 years battery life at 10 seconds broadcast cycle. Third, it can work in the temperature ranges from negative 30 to 80 degrees Celsius. And last and foremost, is the BLE function. Our door sensors can be paired with our TLW1 and TLD1 series trackers. It detects door status and temperatures and transfers the data via BLE to our trackers, which then get reported to tracking platform for remote monitoring. You will know the real-time door status and temperature and be able to receive alarms when the door is open. Alternatively, you can report straight to your phone via BLE when offline if you are standing close enough, and data will show on our BLE accessory app. Reports generated in your phone apps can be sent to you via email. Now, let's continue with the application scenarios. A lot of you might ask, what application can I use the door sensor with? Well, you can pretty much use it on all the doors that you want to monitor, such as vehicle door, container door, trailer door, and the door of your house. It can be used to monitor your delivery truck's door status when they are on the road, and also enable you to monitor your house door status when you are away from home, which gives you a sense of safety. Now let's move on to the installation guide. When you receive the door sensor, this is how it looks like on hand. The first step is to open the case of the sensor. The second step is to remove the strip from the battery. And you will see the power is on when you remove the strip. The last step is to close the lid and please make sure it is tight enough. And now, this is how to attach it to the door. You can use either screws or tape to stabilize the sensor and magnets on the door. Please make sure you put the sensor at one side of the door and the magnet at another side of the door. And the magnet is parallel to the door sensor. It cannot be too high or too low compared to the door sensor. It has to be the same height. More importantly, the distance between the sensor and magnet has to be within 3 centimeters, and the sensor will consider the door open when they are more than 3 centimeters away from each other. As I introduced before, there are two ways of using it, either directly with your phone or via trackers. With your phone, you are not just able to view the door status and temperature data, but you can also configure it and upgrade the firmware. Please download our TFT BLE app. You will see it showing on the app. Click on Complete and enter the password, which will be shown in the user menu. And the first thing you will see is the name. You can change it to any whatever name you want. And you will see a upgrade option for software. Please upgrade when you see it available. The next thing will be the password. You can change the password here. And then it's the broadcast cycle. You can change it to 20 seconds or 30 seconds if you like. And then will be the temperature high alarm and low alarm. The last thing will be the LED. The second way is via tracker. If you want to report to a tracker, then to tracking platform for remote monitoring. First step is to make sure the tracker has BLE feature. Then add a sensor ID to tracker ID list by sending commands to tracker. You can get sensor ID by scanning this QR code here. Now the tracker can pick up the data that the sensor is reporting. You can also set different uploading interval for BLE sensor data when tracking is moving and stopping with this command. Thanks for watching our video. If you like our video, please subscribe below and follow us on LinkedIn. We have a lot more to offer.